السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. Welcome brothers and sisters in Islam to another morning of reciting the Quran, تلقي and تدبر with myself Abdullah Hussein from Masjid Kampong Siglap. And I hope you're having a wonderful morning as I am. And today we begin our session, inshallah, with Ummul Qur'an. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. All praise is due to Allah, Rabbul Izzah, Rabbul Jalal, the Lord of the worlds, the Master of the universe. Peace and blessings be upon our beloved leader and prophet, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, in today's recitation, we begin a new surah, the third surah of the Qur'an, Surah Ali Imran. And the virtues of Surah Ali Imran are many, which we will mention a few of them, inshallah, after our recitation. So let us open our mushafs, or we follow along the text which will be displayed on the screen. And we begin at page 50, verse 1 of Surah Ali Imran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم نزل عليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه وأنزل التوراة والإنجيل من قبل هدى للناس وأنزل الفرقان إن الذين كفروا بآيات الله لهم عذاب شديد والله عزيز ذو انتقام إن الله لا يخفى عليه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء هو الذي يصوركم في الأرحام كيف يشاء لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ مِنْهُ ابْتِغَاءَ الْفِتْنَةِ وَابْتِغَاءَ تَأْوِيلِهِ وَمَا يَعْلَمُ تَأْوِيلَهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ يَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِهِ كل من عند ربنا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد إن الذين كفروا لن تغني عنهم أموالهم لن لن تغني عنهم أموالهم ولا أولادهم من الله شيئا وأولئك هم وقود النار كدأب آل فرعون والذين من قبلهم كذبوا بآياتنا فأخذهم الله بذنوبهم والله شديد العقاب قل للذين كفروا ستغلبون وتحشرون إلى جهنم وبئس المهاد قد كان لكم آية في فئتين التقتا فئة تقاتل في سبيل الله وأخرى كافرة يرونهم مثليهم رأي العين والله يؤيد بنصره من يشاء إن في ذلك لعبرة لأولي الأبصار زين للناس حب الشهوات من النساء والبنين والقناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة والخيل المسومة والأنعام والحرث ذلك متاع الحياة الدنيا والله عنده حسن المآب قل أأنبئكم بخير من ذلكم للذين اتقوا عند ربهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها وأزواج مطهرة ورضوان من الله والله بصير بالعباد. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين. سورة آل عمران the third surah of the Quran. الفاتحة البقرة آل عمران the third surah of the Quran. A great surah full of many virtues as reported in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the virtues, if we look at the first ayat of Al Imran, Alif Lam Mim, and the second ayat, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. There is a specific virtue for this ayat, as there's a hadith reported by Asma binti Yazid, radiyallahu anha, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the greatest names of Allah, Al-Ismul A'zam. What is Al-Ismul A'zam? The names that if you call Allah by those names, your prayer will most certainly be answered. So where can we find Al-Ismul A'zam, the greatest names of Allah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the greatest names of Allah are in two verses. The first verse is verse 163 of Al-Baqarah. The verse is, وَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ. That's the first one. And the second one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in the beginning of Surah Ali Imran, Alif Lam Mim, الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. And this is the same verse, the same part of this verse which Ayatul Kursi also, which is also the greatest ayah in the Quran also, begins with the same الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. That Allah, there is no deity but He. Besides Him, there is none worthy of worship. There is no deity. The one who is Al-Hayy, the ever-living, the one who never dies, Hayyul la yamut, and the one who is Qayyum, the one who sustains everything, and who sustains everyone. Every creation stands in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and every creation from the heavens to the earth is totally reliant on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while Allah is as-samad. Allah is free, Allah is independent, Allah stands in need of nothing, and Allah stands in need of nothing which is created. Subhanallah, this is the greatness of our Creator. The other benefits of Surah Al-Baqarah. So the greatest, remember the first one is that Al-Ismul A'zam. So in your dua, before beginning your dua, you can begin with these verses. وَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ. And you can also recite Alif Lam Mim, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. Another hadith reported by Abu Umama radiyallahu anhu, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اقرأوا القرآن, recite the Quran, for on the day of Qiyamah, it will come as an intercessor for those who recite it. And recite the two shining lights, the two bright ones. What are the two bright and shining lights from the Quran? They are Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran. And for on the day of resurrection, they will come as two clouds or two shades or two flocks of birds in ranks, pleading for those who recite these surahs. So let us recite the surah Al-Baqarah and Al-Imran when we recite the Quran. And just to look at some verses which we ended with today, We'll just read the translation as we do not have that much time. Let us look at verse 14 of Surah Ali Imran. Allah says, "Zuyyina lin-nas," that beautified for people. It is attracted. What is man naturally attracted to? Allah says, "Hubbu shahawati min an-nisa," the love of that which they desire of women. So the number one attraction for man and human is an-nisa, women. The second, wal-baneen, and sons. If a person has a family, everyone, most people desire to have a family, a beautiful wife and beautiful children who they can raise up and will help them and assist them and make their lives easy for them. And the third is والقناطير المقنطرة, and heaps of gold, heaps, قناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة, heaps of gold and silver, a big bank account, many digits in the bank account, everybody's dream to become a millionaire, billionaire, and retire and live a happy life. This is the nature of man who desires more and more wealth, more and more gold. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that if the son of Adam were given a valley of gold, a valley is the space between two mountains. So just imagine two mountains, the space in between full of gold. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said he would wish that he has another one. And what will fill the desire of man? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, nothing will fill his desire except the sand of the grave. So until your death, you are chasing wealth, chasing more gold, more silver, more dollars and pounds. And the next thing is that man is attracted to al-khayl al-musawwamah, which means fine branded horses in today's time. Fine branded cars. Everyone wants to drive a BMW, Mercedes, Benz, Ferrari. These are the fine branded horses of today. The Ferrari also has the logo of a horse on it. So fine branded horses, cars in today's time. This is what man loves. Wal an'ami wal harth, and they love cattle and they love their farmed lands. And Allah says, all these things that you desire and you spend your life chasing after, ذَلِكَ مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, this is nothing but the enjoyment of the worldly life. مَتَاعُ, مَتَاعُ is something which you use for a while and then you throw it away. So these are things which will only last for our lifetime. How long do we live in this world? We have approximately 80 years more or less to live in this world, and then we are going to leave it. So all the enjoyment, you can only enjoy that only for a short time. But Allah says, وَاللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ حُسْنُ الْمَآبِ, even if you have all the wealth in this world, it will definitely come to an end, but Allah has the best return in the end. And verse 15, Allah says, قُلْ أَأُنَبِّئُكُمْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shall I tell you, shall I inform you of something which is better than all those things which were mentioned? لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا, for the one who has taqwa, for the one who fears his creator. عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ, by his Lord, in the presence of his Lord. What will he receive? جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ, he will receive gardens, jannat, gardens, تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ, with rivers flowing beneath there. And the most important thing, خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they will live in there eternally. This is the eternal reward. Even if we get a small reward, but it is forever, it will be enough. But such great is the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so beautiful is his Jannah, that even 1 second in Jannah will be enough for all the hardships that we face in this world. Wa azwajum mutahhara, and purified spouses, and wa ridwanum min Allah, and you will get the pleasure of your Creator, the happiness and the approval from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu basirum bil ibad, and Allah is all seeing. Allah sees what you do. Allah knows what you do. So let us keep this in mind. And strive to enter into Jannah, insha'Allah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and grant you barakah in your time today. And may He enter us all into Jannah and grant us His ridwan and His pleasure. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Until we meet again next time, stay safe. Fi amanillah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.